Hi, this is Gemini Dhar. I'm a take charge expert and author, and I work with women and children to empower them. I have written a book, 9 Ways to Empower, and I have shared Anand's mom story and Anand's story in my book. And Anand is a very, very busy person and a very, very special friend. I know him from last 2 years, and Anand has probably conquered each and every height in this world. And we were just talking in our Marathi interview that he may go to Mars and try to climb a mountain over there. That is his belief system. He has a very, very strong belief. So
we're
going to.
That's why I got information about Mars. It is the highest mountain on Mars, is Olympus Mons. So one day I will surely climb that mountain.
I can't even think about it. So you can think how big is this wide. He's not thinking global, he's thinking universal. So you never know. Tomorrow, and if he goes there, he'll bring me some gifts
definitely,
from there. Yeah,
definitely.
From Mars, some stones, some rocks. You know,
yes, yes, definitely, definitely.
So, what I really, really want to share today with Anand is his story about failures. Anand will introduce himself. He will, in short, you have to tell us about yourself. We know you have climbed each and every mountain on Earth.
Yes.
So you are a globetrotter. But the best part about Anand is he supports girl child. He supports women. He's working very actively with United Nations. And he has got loads. I mean, if you go into his profile, I have 15 to 20 pages of profile of Anand talking about himself. But Anand, introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Anand Bansode. I have climbed 4 top mountains in 4 continents, including Everest, Mount Kilimanjaro, Elbrus, and Mount Kosciuszko.
I want to interrupt.
Yeah.
I have been to Mount Kilimanjaro, but
oh,
from
wow.
the air.
Oh, wow.
I haven't climbed it. I've just
okay.
seen it from the top.
Means
you know.
You have just seen a top.
Yeah, but
yeah.
I didn't know you but then. Otherwise, I would have searched for you. Must be somewhere in the mountain. Okay.
I have written 5 books, motivational books, and I'm working with United Nations as a global youth advocate for gender equality cause. And I'm working for He for She. I'm Girl Rising ambassador. And I'm doing lots of things. I'm corporate trainer, corporate speaker, and I'm working with girl child, as Gemini said. And yeah, that's it.
And I feel very proud to know him, because the amount of work he's doing for women, it's something incredible. If I have a son, I mean my son, if he would be as motivated and as power believes like Anand, I would be really, really proud mother.
Wow,
like his mother
much.
Is.
Thank you very
and,
much.
And today we are going to share something about failure and setting goals. Anand, you started climbing the mountain. It didn't happen in one day.
Yeah.
Okay. You must have fallen down many times.
Yes.
You must
yes.
have hurt yourself. You
yes.
must have gone through a lot of things in life.
Yes.
So what was your belief system, and what are the things you did that made you reach the first mountain that you conquered?
I had lots of belief system that my childhood was lots of failure, like filled with lots of failure, lots of setback, and I had a belief system that I'm not good with anything. Like I faced lots of insult in my school, in my house, and I wish I was thinking in my childhood that I should reach such height that no one should come there to insult me.
Yo.
So that was my first belief. That I could, I would climb.
Your reason, your
yeah,
driving
my,
reason.
My reason, yeah, yeah. And it all came from that negative situation. So there is a seeds in negative situation to reach reach such height.
So he has used his negative situation, the bad
yeah.
experiences in life, the hurt and insult in life, to do something constructive and to bring out a very, very positive outcome from there,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
So
yeah. After that, I have done my education, 11th, 12th, and then I started working for my Everest expedition, and I have failed many times in courses, mountaineering courses too, and I have done one mountain, that is a Virgin mountain in 2010. I have climbed T2 mountain, which was Virgin, and I was the first human being to reach on top of T2. So it gave me a lots of confidence, and I got a second belief that I can do anything. And
so
after that,
he started, he did the first thing thinking that he wants to be on top and he wants to be the best, so that nobody is going to ever question his self-worth, and then he did it.
Yes.
So then that power
yes.
belief came that I can
yeah,
yeah.
And after that, instead of having lots of economical problem, I spent like a 20 lakhs rupees on a Everest, for my economical situation. That is the, like, lots of people can say it is impossible for you to climb the mountain, but I did it. I just saying that I can do it one day.
And
And I did it.
And how does it feel?
Yeah, it feels nice. Like now I have another self-belief that I can do anything in any bad situation.
So talking of failures, failure is something which did not hold Anand back. He was persistent. He kept going. He kept going. So now you're working for Girl Child and you are working for a lot of other international organizations. So what is your next goal?
My next goal is complete my 7th summit with the social cause with United Nations. I'm working as a global youth advocate. And
give some advice to the youth. There are a lot of young girls and a lot of young women and a lot of young children watching
especially
you.
Especially for girls, don't feel that you are like less than someone or something. Just focus on inside and you have all the limitless powers within you. Just focus on that power and you can achieve anything in your life. Yeah.
And do you want to share a story about any girl child or anybody you have spoken to or the kind of stories you get in your UN? I would want to share some small story or something about, you know, about how your belief can really, really... see, I meet a lot of girls and women in my career. So when I'm talking to them and we are talking about empowerment, most of the time they feel that they do not have those. They have to get it from outside. So it is only a self-realization when you do a couple of things in life and when you gain confidence.
I know one girl from Bangalore, she lost her hand in, I don't know, some accident. But she was away from society since like... her childhood because she doesn't have two hands actually. But now she just get out of that comfort zone and she became the disabled ambassador of United Nations. So she's amazing. I have heard when I was in United Nations last March, I have heard her speech and it was totally motivating. And I should feel that every girl, every person, not even girl, every person has that kind of capability, that kind of potential to get out of comfort zone instead of having lots of negative things.
And one thing about comfort zone, Anand's mother tongue is Marathi. He is very happy speaking Marathi, but he's done a TED talk.
Yeah.
And when I heard his TED talk, I was really moved because he is talking about life and death, you know, like your cylinder was over and you had just a couple of moments. So he has gone through various experiences in life, which has really, really added that spark to it.
Definitely.
And he's like, he is an inspirational figure for tons of people.
If you see your death in front of you, you will learn how to live the life. So that I have seen many times.
So Anand, thank you so much for talking to me.
Thank you. We can go
on because we are going to do one more Hindi interview for all the Hindi viewers because I found him after six months. I was just joking the other time that if I did not catch him today, I would have to go to Mount Everest to find him. So this is an easier way to find him here in Mumbai. And he's just done a radio interview and we're waiting to hear that too.
Yeah.
So like, subscribe and share and we'll hear a lot about from Anand in future also.
Yeah.
And Anand has been a very, very driving and supporting force after me being an author, my first ISBN number given by Anand Bansode, my book being translated in Marathi by Anand Bansode. So he's been a strand, so he's a real, when he says he supports women, he does, because I know a lot of people, but very few will come forward and do something selflessly, and that is Anand.
thank you very much, Gemini.